Hey, what's up? It's Taka here. Welcome back to my weekly video. So I've done filming the next video for Devil's Life, and I'm currently editing it, and it should be available next week. So I'd like to talk about the plugin updates thanks to the community effort of the Inkdrop. So there are some updates, and the first one is embed plugin. It's for embedding content from the internet to your notes. So for example, you can embed Gist and YouTube and Twitter. And now it supports Vimeo. It supports Vimeo. Oh, that's so cool. And that is thanks to not applicable the contribution. So he sent me a pull request. And so this is thanks to him, his effort. Thank you. And the next one is interesting. So it's for ChatGPT integration. So you can use ChatGPT from Inkdrop. That is so interesting. So let me show you a demo. So let's say you, so I've already installed the AskGPT plugin, and you can write a prompt like so. So you, let's say you are running Python, and you'd like to know how to remove the Japanese open bracket and close bracket at the beginning and end from a string if it appears. And so you can write it like so, and select the text and right click and AskGPT and ask. Then it calls the OpenAI API. And you've got a response, you've got answer from the GPT, and that here is answer. You can remove remove the Japanese bracket by calling strip. That's so cool. The plugin has several features like translation. So if you wanna translate konnichiwa to English, right click and ask GPT and select translate. Then it calls a completion API, and you can get a translation like hello in English. That's because the plugin has several presets, prompt presets, and this is one of them. So this is so interesting. You can use ChatGPT, completion API, directly from the Inkdrop. So you don't have to leave the note, and you don't have to copy and paste from the ChatGPT window. That is so useful. And, so I was actually thinking of creating it myself, but he did it. So thank you for creating. It's Libre. You can try it. It's already available on the plugin registry here. It's called AskGPT. Yes. And the next one is called Furigana. Furigana means Ruby, and it'll be useful for Japanese or Chinese learners. And it can add the text above the text. So as you can see here, so you can add the text above, and you can add some annotation above the text. It's so useful for Japanese learners, like how to read kanjis, Chinese characters, like so. Oh, thank you for creating Toto 553. Yes, so I've done filming the next video for Deva's Life, and I filmed it in Tenma. Tenma is in Osaka, and there is a river, and also there are a lot of cherry blossoms like this, and it's very beautiful, and I wanted to film it I wanted to film here. I wanted to film according tutorial here. And I found a great place to film a tutorial. It's a rental place. It's a rental space. It's a paid place, but as you can see, it has a great view. And here is the result. So that view was just stunning. And I'm so excited to have get this result. I'm currently editing it, and this is a photo, and I've edited it on Lightroom, and I found that I learned a technique to make it cinematic, and that is to use color grading section. So I've been using a color mixer and other lighting settings, but I find that color grading section is also very powerful. So in this photo, I increased the shadows here and decreased highlights here, and to make it more like dreamy or soft looking. So it's very beautiful. Yeah, so you should try it if you want to make it cinematic. So I can't wait to publish it next week. So thank you for watching and have a productive day.